Ray Kurzweil is here. He has been called the rightful heir to Thomas Edison.
I read your book, some of the most frightening and yet hopeful stuff I've ever read.
Ray Kurzweil is a pioneer in the field of artificial intelligence.
He's an award-winning scientist and engineer.
He's the holder of 24 patents.
Ray Kurzweil
was chief inventor of the flatbed scanner.
A reading machine for the blind, Kurzweil keyboard synthesizer.
Bill Gates has called him the best in the world at predicting the future.
When Ray Kurzweil makes a prediction, lots of folks listen.
Kurzweil sees a day when microscopic computers will make all kinds of learning as easy as downloading.
You're saying millions of tiny computers floating around in my head?
There won't be a clear distinction between humans and machines.
Our computers are not going to be these rectangular devices we put in our pocket. They're going to be inside our bodies and brains, and we're going to be a hybrid of biological and non-biological intelligence.
This is what I wanted to cover today. Any questions on any of this? The major theme that I'd like to share with you is that what is driving this acceleration of change is the exponential growth of information technology. And this is not intuitive. We have an intuition about the future. It is an axiom that the only thing that's constant is change. But change is actually not a constant. It's growing exponentially.
Health and medicine is now undergoing a grand transformation.
We now have the genome. We have means of changing it. Human life expectancy is not a constant. 15 years from now, we'll be adding more than a year every year, not to infant life expectancy, but to your remaining life expectancy. Within about 20 years, we'll be able to actually fabricate just about anything we need from inexpensive information resources. We'll be able to have millions of blood cell-sized devices inside our bodies, keeping us healthy from inside.
Energy, that doesn't seem like information technology, but that will also be revolutionized.
We came forth with a program that within 20 years can completely replace fossil fuels with solar energy, because we actually have 10,000 times more sunlight than we need. In other words, if we captured one part in 10,000 of the sunlight that falls in the Earth, we could meet 100% of our energy needs.
Ultimately, we'll be information technology that provides future economic growth.
If we go to 2029, we will understand human intelligence. I think that will give us greater insight into ourselves. It won't replace the mystery or eliminate the mystery, but we'll have greater insight as to who we are. That's been a goal of the arts and sciences for millennia.
And the tools of creativity are really now in all of our hands. A couple of students at Stanford with their $1,000 laptops wrote a little bit of software and revolutionized web search, and their company is now worth $150 billion.
And we use these tools to expand our intelligence. That is the nature of being human. That's the unique thing about the human species. We didn't stay in the ground, we didn't stay on the planet, we didn't stay with the limitations of our biology. We extend our reach. We use these tools to expand who we are.
So if you can hang in there